In this video, we're going to talk about how to test and check an evaporative emission system for leaks using a smoke test. Let's talk about the equipment that we're going to use. So this is a SnapOn smart smoke machine. Evaporative test equipment like this and smoke machines largely all offer the same types of features. This just happens to be the one that we've got. And so a couple things, I've got to give it 12 volts. So I've got two leads back here that I'm going to have to hook up to the vehicle battery or a jump pack. I've got a pneumatic fitting right here on the back of the machine. This is going to go to, in our case, a nitrogen tank, or if I was doing a intake leak on the engine, right, the air intake system of the engine, or a wind leak for a door seal, I could just use shop air. But because we're putting this into the fuel system, we don't want to add oxygen to that system if we can avoid it. So I've got that hooked up. The other output here is this hose. This is my smoke output. So it comes out in just this small hose. And in a minute, we'll look at the adapters we need. Then up front on the controls, I've got a variety of things. I've got a display, in this case is digital. Many of these will use a analog gauge and a flow meter. This one does all that digitally. So I can turn on and select what my display is showing me based on these parameters. So I can look for leak size, the flow, pressure, or vacuum. I can indicate the type of leak orifice that I'm after, right? And so that's useful because we know our EVAP monitor is looking for specific orifice size. I can match that on the tool and look for that. My start button's down here. That's going to allow me to run it. Generally, these will run for a period of time. This one happens to be 5 minutes. Included in our testers, I've got these little sets with a variety of different components, extra regulator, caps and things that we might use when doing intake leak checks or looking for exhaust leaks and other things. This fuel filler adapter is great for vehicles where I don't have an EVAP service port under the hood, so this allows me to easily put smoke into the system. All right, so I've got 12 volts into my machine. We've got the nitrogen tank open. We're gonna go ahead and run it, make sure we've got smoke output. So I turn it on, it will take a moment. These operate by heating an oil. So there's an oil within a chamber with a heating element. It's a lot like a model train in terms of how it creates its smoke. The other unique thing about this is that the Snap-on oil, in this case, has a UV dye in it. So over time, a trace would be created if we had a pretty excessive leak. So I'm going to come back to the fuel door. This vehicle does not have a EVAP test port under the hood, and so we're going to use the filler neck adapter to provide an input for our smoke. I do want to be cautious that whenever I test an EVAP system this way, I am eliminating the fuel filler cap from my diagnosis and my leak check, and so I need to really pay close attention to this to make sure that I don't miss something like a faulty gas cap for an EVAP leak. So we put the adapter on, it just goes right around the filler neck. I can add my smoke input, and now we're almost ready for the test. So the next thing we've got to do before we start the test is that we've got to use a scan tool to close the EVAP system in order to leak check it. So EVAP systems utilize a vent valve that generally has a normally open position. So that means I'm going to have to electrically close it to seal the system and allow this test to happen. So I'm going to use a scan tool here and navigate through how to do that. I'm going to go to a previous vehicle because we've used this Regal before. And so I've got to first pull up my vehicle, go into the PCM, and what I'm looking for is a functional test or a special test. So I should be able to come into that, look for some kind of control or test. So in this case, I don't see it on this list. I'm going to go to output controls, navigate through here. And here we go, EVAP purger seal, vent solenoid valve. The purge seal will do it, as well as this vent valve selection here. So what I want to do is come in and tell it to not vent, and that's going to help seal up the system so that I can fill it with the smoke from the tester and check for leaks. All right, so we're back to our tester here. We're going to get it started so we can conduct the test. As we saw before, it's always a great idea with a tool like this to verify that it's working. So we did that, we turned it on, we looked for smoke output to ensure that this piece of equipment is functioning the way that it should. So I'm gonna go ahead and push the start button. I get a light that tells me it is on. My leak size, it says right now, full leak, right? Meaning that it's completely being pushed through and now it's beginning to drop. So whenever I work with a smoke test machine like this, there are two things I really wanna look for. One is the flow. When I turn this on, I wanna watch the flow. And if the system is really sealed, I should see this number change, right? Similarly, if I take the hose and I pinch it, I should see that flow number drop drastically. That's a sign that the system is filling and building pressure, right? And so that's a good test to make sure that things are going that the way that they should. The other thing I can do is look at pressure. So on this one, you have to go here to pressure in inches of water, and I can read that pressure. And again, I expect this number to climb as I fill the system with smoke and with this propellant, right? I should see that pressure build. If I've got a really gross leak, those things may not happen. I may not see the flow change. I may not see the pressure increase, but that's where the smoke comes into play because it's evident when I have a leak. So here, if we put our display back up to the orifice leak size, right now it shows a pass and it shows that it's at about a 20/1000th leak rate. We should see that number drop a little bit more as the system continues to fill. And again, these numbers are correlating with the general EVAP monitor and the thresholds that they look at. So most systems are either going to add vacuum to the system and look for a decay, or in some cases pump and add pressure to the system. In either event, the decay or the ability for that system to hold a vacuum or pressure is going to be measured in the orifice size like this, because that's part of our global OBD2 and monitor structure. So that's our process to go through this EVAP leak check. Unfortunately, this vehicle does not have an active leak, right? So we don't have the other scope of work that would go with this. But some of the normal things that we would do, we would get this set up and running, look for that drop, and then begin to survey the vehicle and look for visual signs of a leak. Look for smoke emitting from one of the hoses or one of the parts of this system. And so there are some common things. One is the fuel cap. Right, and so this way that we've connected, again, we've got to be careful because we're not testing this fuel cap and its seal at this point. It's common for fuel caps to fail or for the O-ring to become brittle and crack, creating a leak. We also see on some higher mileage vehicles, the filler neck may create or begin to build some corrosion where that seal does no longer fit well against the filler neck, right? And so we might have to take a close inspection about that. Hoses, lines are all common places we see leaks. The other issue that we see in a lot of vehicles is that the vent valve's ability to close gets compromised. And so one of the common ones in my mind that I saw as a tech was on Toyotas, that the vent valve assembly would commonly become restricted and clogged basically from debris, spiders, insects, and the valve would lose its ability to seal because that debris was there within the solenoid. And on that particular model, the whole EVAP canister would get replaced as part of that sequence. So EVAP canister, the vent valve, the purge valve, all these things are things that we're gonna have to check if we suspect that we've got a leak. But the great thing about this tool is that the smoke is a great visual indicator to see what's happening. I've just gotta remember to use my scan tool, close the system and seal it, and make sure that I checked first that my tool is working and emitting a smoke.